Good afternoon. Anyone who doubts that the war on whistleblowers is a backdoor war on journalists should study the case of Jim Risen. Threats to reporters are the undercurrent in the Obama administration's record-setting Espionage Act prosecutions of so-called leakers. One example where the press is implicated is when the Justice Department subpoenaed Associated Reporters' phone records impacting over 100 different journalists. In the case of another whistleblower, Stephen Kim, the Justice Department got a search warrant on the reporter, Jim Rosen, by claiming that he was a, quote, co-conspirator. In the case of my client, Edward Snowden, the administration has made noises about reporter Glenn Greenwald being an aider and abettor. Considering the Obama administration's use of the Espionage Act to chill speech, it should be no surprise that threats against Risen also come from an Espionage Act prosecution of another whistleblower, Jeff Sterling, and Risen's honorable commitment to protect a source who revealed a disastrous government operation gone wrong. Whistleblowers need the press. There are no safe and effective internal channels for most national security and intelligence whistleblowers. Channels that do exist often turn whistleblowers into targets of retaliation and rarely correct the underlying wrongdoing, especially when the wrongdoing is perpetrated by senior levels of the U.S. government. The press, I would submit, also needs whistleblowers. Journalists depend on whistleblower sources to report critical information in the public interest. Without whistleblowers, journalists would struggle to unpack government and corporate spin without differing perspectives or, in many cases, documentary evidence. As a whistleblower attorney, there are a small but essential handful of reporters I feel confident will accurately report information and protect their sources. Jim Risen is one of them, and if he is jailed or forced to pay harsh daily fines, the pool of reporters who know whistleblowers are essential for accurate reporting will become even smaller. The threats to Jim Risen are an attack on the entire First Amendment, most prominently the right to a free press, but also the right to speak and associate with whistleblowers and reporters. Government surveillance of reporters, subpoenaing of reporters to testify against their own sources, and threatening them with contempt of court create a freezing atmosphere where neither whistleblowers nor reporters are safe to hold the government accountable and keep the public informed. Committing journalism is not a crime. The notion that it is a dangerous trend we should deprive of oxygen. It demands that the government withdraw the subpoena of reporter Jim Risen immediately. Thank you.